all good things must come to an end, as the old adage goes. And that may be the case quite literally. It may be that everything in the universe will someday cease to exist. The universe might be left as a kind of ghost made up of elementary particles giving no hint of the atomic world that once was. Or it could be rendered a frozen wasteland full of cinders forever. Or maybe it will come to a violent end, only for a new universe to rise from the ashes. The fact is, we don't exactly know how the universe will come to an end, but we do have some ideas on just how it might unfold and when. So here are 10 ways the universe might ultimately come to an end. Number 10, the Big Rip. The universe may have just 22 billion years left to live. Conventional thinking has been that the universe is young at 13.8 billion years, and it contains stars that could live trillions of years longer than the sun will even exist. Fully convective red dwarfs efficiently fusing hydrogen for unbelievable amounts of time. But in a different framework, thinking about its end as a big rip, the universe is already at a possible full third of its total age. In reality, it could actually be a universe approaching middle age. The universe is all that is, was, or ever will be, including time itself, and that could come to an abrupt end. The key here is dark energy, and its battle with gravity. It's currently winning, but it could change, or it could win in a very big way. There are many unknowns here, but what we do know is that gravity is incredibly weak on the scale of the atom, almost non-existent compared to the other forces of nature. Can it get so bad, however, that dark energy can rip apart the atom? A question here is how resistant the universe, space-time, is to expansion and contraction. This is called cosmological viscosity, how much it can stretch and move in response to dark energy's influence. The idea ultimately is that the expansion of the universe will not only accelerate, but could become infinite in nature. Bad news, because the end result is that everything simply rips apart, and so ends the universe. Number 9, the Big Bounce. The origins of the universe remain a somewhat poorly understood area of science to this day. We have insights, more than ever before, but really don't know why the Big Bang happened, nor do we know what, if anything, existed before it. Sometimes within cosmology, hypotheses can come on the table that at first seem viable, but as more information comes to light, they fall into the background, as less likely. But other times they can make a comeback, and one such instance is the idea of a big bounce. This is a cyclic model for the universe, where it's all just a huge repeating oscillation that explodes, expands, collapses, and starts the whole situation over. With the advent of cosmic inflation, however, the big bounce idea was for a time less viable and basically unnecessary. More recent questions arising from inflation have brought it back to a degree. If this is the case, however, then it has to be asked. Is this the first iteration of the universe, or is it one of many? Or has it always occurred and represents an infinitely repeating process with no beginning? In which case, the universe will at some point reverse itself and fall inward instead of expanding. It's worth noting, though, that the expansion of the universe is accelerating, perhaps standing against the idea of universal death and the birth of a new universe in the aftermath of the bounce. Number 8, the heat death of the universe. The cold and the dark. This isn't a very optimistic view of the end of the universe, rather a sort of sad one. Here, dark energy simply accelerates the expansion of the universe to the point that everything reaches a heat death. It all becomes a cold, featureless, utterly dark abyss. More technically, the universe ceases to have any thermodynamic free energy, and there is no longer a driver of entropy. Rather, the universe reaches thermodynamic equilibrium, and nothing much happens after that. This requires that the universe expands forever. Which, if what we suspect about dark energy is true, and the geometry of the universe is flat or hyperbolic, that sets the stage for the heat death. But there is an oddity here, in that the original concept of a Boltzmann brain was that of a spontaneous thinking system, a brain, appearing as a result of entropy fluctuations, inside a universe that's been in a heat death state for untold amounts of time. It would be a place where the ghosts of consciousness, which once pervaded it, surface and dissipate occasionally across the vastness of time. Number 7. The catastrophic collapse of the Higgs field. The discovery, or really the confirmation of the Higgs boson, is recent, 2012, but was predicted to exist in 1964. It was one of those instances where multiple indicators suggested that it should exist and be responsible for the phenomenon of mass in the universe, but was awaiting confirmation for a very long period of time. It was confirmed, and now we're in the period where everyone hypothesizes just what it actually means and what it could do, and it could spell the end of the universe. The issue here is that we know what the Higgs boson does at this point, but we don't know what its lowest possible mass could be. It might just be sitting at a stable point right now, in a situation that might change. Think of it like a mountain. You can push a rock over a mountain, and it will never be likely to ever climb back up over it. But it can fall and rest in a depression lower down, but not at the bottom. One earthquake or other factor might push it out of the valley and further down the mountain. Can't go back up, but can go further down. This might be how some aspects of the universe are, such as the Higgs. But particles can also behave as waves, meaning they don't really have defined edges. They are more like smears across space-time, meaning that they can tunnel through the bottom of the valley and end up at the bottom. And therein is the problem. If the Higgs field lends the property of mass to the rest of the universe, if the rules change, then chemistry and everything else undergoes a change to the rules. So ends us if it happens. And it may already have happened, in that the change would propagate at the speed of light. So if it happened in some far corner of the universe, the changed status quo will simply hit us without warning, and we instantly vanish. What kind of universe that lies within the great bubble front of destruction is unknown. Number 6. A second Big Bang. Related to the last entry, this entry is based on recent work and trying to figure out just how the Higgs boson itself could become destabilized to catastrophic results. Thankfully, if this is possible, it's not likely to happen anytime soon, rather many trillions of years in the future. Unless the process has started somewhere in the universe and is propagating at the speed of light. But what could destabilize the Higgs boson? The answer may be supermassive black holes. We don't entirely know exactly what happens inside the event horizon of a black hole. Our physics basically breaks down and starts predicting incorrectly and nonsensically in this environment. It's been suggested that this might be a mechanism for changing the properties of the Higgs eventually, in which case it would result in an effective but very different second Big Bang, propagating through the universe, destroying everything in its path. Number 5. The Big Crunch. Gravity, as we all know, is an attractive force. It draws matter towards it. In the Big Bang, however, this tendency was defeated by the titanic explosion that was the dawn of the universe. Past that, galaxies are flying in all directions, and the universe overall is expanding. But will it do that forever? The answer is probably not, but we can't entirely be sure. Evidence seems to be pointing against a big crunch, but therein is a wild card, dark energy. We know almost nothing about this energy other than its existence seems to be required to drive the expansion of the universe. Currently, this is accelerating. However, given that we know nothing about it, if that property changes at some point to some other value, then it could result in the collapse of the universe. This leads to a truly terrifying far future scenario. We'll be long gone, as will Earth. But at some point, if the expansion of the universe begins to reverse, any civilizations existing at this time are going to see what might be the most terrifying sight possible in the universe. The collapse will begin gradually, and if it does indeed occur, we'll be at least another 14 billion years from now. First, astronomers will notice differences in the blue shifting of galaxies. Redshift will gradually disappear. Billions of years later, this will lead to all of the galaxies of the universe coming into close proximity. Depending on when this might happen dictates what anyone would see. If there are stars left, they might see them in ever denser groups in the sky. If the remaining stars are all red dwarfs and low mass stars, neutron stars, black holes, etc., then they might not see much of anything other than a black sky, unaware of the impending crunch. All of these galaxy mergers will produce a burst of new star formation, though, as remaining hydrogen clouds coalesce. supermassive black holes will grow in mass as they merge with those of other galaxies. Even the cosmic microwave background radiation itself would begin to blue shift and grow in intensity. The Big Crunch scenario is actually worse than the Big Bang was. It's actually the most catastrophic thing that can happen in the universe, above and beyond a Big Bang. Though a second one of those would not be good. At some point, everything will get so hot that no civilizations will survive it. Eventually, as the heat increases, as does the blue shift, even the surfaces of stars will begin to burn with nuclear fusion, destroying them. They will literally tear themselves apart with nuclear detonations. Finally, either a big bounce happens, or the universe returns to what it once was, a singularity, opening up the possibility of a new Big Bang. Number 4. The decay of the proton. The idea that all matter could someday vanish is both spooky but also a possibility. One major way in which this could happen is the hypothesized decay of the proton itself. The idea that the proton might not be completely stable is old and still unresolved, first being advanced by Andrei Sakharov in 1967. How it works is this. The proton wouldn't normally be expected to spontaneously decay on its own in the standard model. It should be indefinitely stable. But when one starts exploring other theories beyond the standard model, usually in hopes of finding a grand unified theory of everything, the possibility of proton decay comes onto the table. There are different ideas on what would happen, but one is that the proton would decay into a neutral, pion, and a positron, which is antimatter. Should this happen, then atoms simply could no longer exist, and over time, an immense amount of time, the matter of the universe would continually erode, eventually bringing it to an effective end. Experiments to look into whether the proton does or does not decay have come up negative. At least right now, it doesn't appear to decay. But the question remains open and awaiting a grand unified theory to answer the question. Though it's possible, we may never achieve that. Number 3. The experiment that goes horribly wrong. One thing about physics is clear. We don't know everything. In our partial view of the workings of the universe, we can do remarkable things. Physics allows for the design and construction of automobiles, computers, Dyson swarms, and fusion reactors. But there are areas of physics that are shrouded in mystery, such as the nature of what's inside the event horizon of a black hole, or exactly how the universe unfolded before about 300 million years after the Big Bang. Given that there are huge gaps in our knowledge, you have to ask, will we ever have a complete view of physics, or does the universe simply not allow for it? If the universe doesn't allow for it, then it's not only going to affect humans, but all alien civilizations that come up against the same brick walls. As a result, it's conceivable that through increasingly powerful experimentation, we, or alien civilizations, might accidentally stumble across some unknown area of physics that can literally precipitate the end of the universe by targeting its very most basic underpinnings, many of which we may not be aware of. In other words, the wrong experiment for what you think are the right reasons may have the unintended result of damaging or ending the universe. Number 2. The vacuum decay of the universe. Within quantum field theory, there is the concept of a false vacuum. It's exactly what it sounds like, a hypothetical vacuum. An area of space with as little energy in it as possible that's stable, sort of, but isn't sitting in its most stable basic state, meaning it's metastable and could tunnel to a true vacuum in principle. But it's not totally empty, there are still quantum fields there, and could create local minimums of energy, but not ones that extend the whole universe. That opens up the path for false vacuum states. That may not sound scary, and I'm not saying it's scary, but it's scary. The thing is, this idea of a false vacuum starts at some point looking like the universe. If it is indeed in a false vacuum state, then it could decay to a lower, more stable state at any time. This could result in changes to the fundamental forces that govern the universe, to the point that matter itself cannot exist in the same state that it had before the change. Or even minor changes. Alterations to the situation now that completely change the properties of physics and the elements or chemistry. A new normal could develop. But one thing is clear, that new normal is not our normal, and we exit stage left, even if some kind of new life might arise after the event. Number 1. The simulation comes to an end. There are some questions that science can't really answer that can be legitimately asked. Science is about measurement and hypothesizing and proving. But there are also aspects of the universe that may not be measurable, can't be proven or disproven, and may forever remain a mystery. One of these is the actual nature of the universe in the sense of whether it's a natural, unthinking realm or if it's actually something else. Perhaps chief among this weirdness is the idea that the universe could be some type of simulation. There are arguments for and against the simulation hypothesis. Some make the argument that there is simply no need to invoke the idea of a simulation in a universe that to us and everything we can measure is all too real. But from the philosophical side, a case can be made that a simulation makes the most sense, and that if the right things are true, then we almost certainly live in a simulation of some kind. What that really means is still unclear, and perhaps always will be, but within this is a question. If the simulation was designed to reach some kind of end, at what point does it stop making sense to run it at all? This obviously would depend on its purpose, if it has one. But regardless of questions of who made the simulation, if anyone, and why, there is always the possibility that it could simply turn off at any time, for any arbitrary reason, and all that we see around us could disappear as though a television were being turned off or a YouTube video ended and closed. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently concerned about the universe's well-being. The one common theme in this video was that none of the entries represented a particularly good end for the universe. I, for one, hope it's alright, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.